This time we are going all in 500 Hz. In the following video you can learn about the best way to connect a CRT monitor to a modern computer, and you can see how we drive this Yama CRT here to 200 Hz and beyond, and we will even test 500 Hz later. At the end of the video we will search the internet together for adapters that are available and that you can buy. Alright, let's dive into this. As you may have already guessed, this video will be about VGA to DisplayPort or HDMI adapters. And let me tell you this right now, sadly 90% of the adapters that you can buy for cheap on Amazon or other sites suck. And the problem is they won't tell you that they suck until you try them out and realize this yourself. But let's start at the beginning. This is your standard VGA to DisplayPort adapter, and from the look they are all the same. This is the same model that is currently connected to this monitor. Alright, as you see here we currently have 85 Hz. And now let me show you what happens when we try to drive this PC higher. Let's say we want to go 100 Hz, but let's be gentle, we don't want to do this at a higher resolution, we do it at a lower resolution. This is an absolute must here. But as you see, it doesn't work. Now the picture comes again. And we are once again at 85 Hz. Alright, we have just switched now to 1600 times 1200. That's a resolution you could actually work with this CRT. But not at 85 Hz, of course. So now we are trying to go higher here. And as you saw, we tried to go to 90 Hz and it failed. So there's no point in continuing here. Now we have changed the adapter that is connected to our computer to this one. This is a DeLock adapter that I found a few years ago and that I'm using ever since. As you see here, this adapter supports a resolution of up to 2560 times 1600 at 60 Hz. But what is important to us is that it supports a pixel clock of 270 MHz. This gives us a lot of options in lower resolutions too. Okay, as you see, we are once again at our well-known 85 Hz, still at 1600 times 1200. Now we are going higher. Alright, we are going right now all the way up to 100 Hz, which is a good setting for this resolution and this monitor. This time it worked. As you see, here's 100 Hz and apply. And let's see. There we go, 100 Hz. Now really working. But this is not all this adapter can do. If we go to a lower resolution, like 800 times 600, we can go to up to 200 Hz. And this is actually usable for gaming still. And some players who really want the best possible speed use the monitor exactly like this. Nothing is faster right now. Alright, now we are also changing to this resolution in Windows. And as you see, here we are. Let's make the quick check. 202 Hz is it with 136 kHz. So we are closer to the limit of the monitor now. But we haven't reached it yet. Next, 250 Hz. Let's see. We have reduced the resolution further. Still playable, still usable. But in modern Windows has problems with that. But it's working with some go-arounds. And as you see here, 255 Hz. Alright, let's get more crazy here. This monitor is kinda unlocked in its Hz, so it's only limited by the kilohertz, which is absolutely fabulous and makes it very unique. And here we go. Have you ever seen 400 Hz on a CRT before? Let's apply it in Windows quick. But this is not really a usable resolution in Windows. Okay, let's do one more. This time we are going all in 500 Hz. Damn, nice. I try to zoom the picture out a bit, but and let's okay, the menu doesn't show the hertz anymore. It's further down, but you see at the kilohertz that we have the maximum available. So we really have 500 hertz on a CRT monitor from 2002 right now. All right, enough fun for now. Let me give you a few tips on what you can check if the DisplayPort adapter you're looking for is okay or not. I tell you, I'm not sure we find one that is okay. As you see here, this one here already states it does 60 hertz at 1080. So of course it's not good enough for us. Then we have one here. This is 300 plus bought in past months. Yeah, let's hope those weren't gamers. Ah, here it even tells you it has 162 megahertz. Remember, ours has 270. That's what you need. I have one more here. This one doesn't state at all. That's often also the case. You don't really know what it does. They don't tell you. Here's one more. This one was even sold 3K plus last month. So let's hope those weren't gamers. It's incredible performance. Take a look. We have an incredible performance of 60 hertz at 1080. So laughable. We have a StarTech here. I even have one of those, and I can already tell you it also doesn't do what we need. I mean, don't get me wrong, those aren't bad adapters. The problem is, they were not made for gamers in mind, because the trend that everyone wants to play modern games on fast CRTs was not known a few years ago. So who's to blame them for not producing the stuff? Right, I will check now if the adapter that I recommended to you is still available somewhere. I'm not sure here. I have found this here. This is an adapter for USB Type-C, and it also does VGA, but it does 4K with 60 hertz, which would be great. But here on VGA, it only does 60 hertz at 1080. So if they don't write it, it often doesn't work then. That's my experience. So I will continue to look. All right, I got lucky after all. That's a German store, but they also send Europe-wide or worldwide. Here we go. Aldernate has exactly mine. You see, with the 2560 times 1600 at 60 hertz. And here, as I told you, if they can do it, they usually will tell you, because it's good. And if they leave it away, you can be pretty sure they don't want to tell you that they suck. But that's the only one I found, guys. And I think that the video is long enough now. So I wish you good luck. I hope you find one of those if you haven't one already. And if any one of you knows more DisplayPort adapters that can do this, write it in the comments so others, on YouTube at least, can maybe find more with my video. Right, good luck, guys. Everyone, have a good time. Bye.